President Alfonsine, and distinguished guests and ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure for me to welcome you to the White House, and I thoroughly enjoyed meeting with President Alfonsine today. Our discussions were cordial and productive, and of course today was not the first meeting that we've had. Last September we met just before attending the United Nations General Assembly. That was in the midst of our presidential campaign last September, and I remember that you remarked that although being president is a hard job, sometimes getting there is even harder. President Alfonsine and I have much in common. We both have gone through many campaigns and asked for votes from many different kinds of people. Down in Texas during the 1976 primary, they had me out knocking on doors. And I remember one kind of rural area. I'd been governor of California, but I wasn't all that well known in Texas, and I knocked on the door, and an old fellow in his undershirt and jeans came to the door, and I told him I was running for president, and having been in the occupation I'd been in for a number of years, I was kind of surprised when he asked me what I'd done for a living. And I told him I'd been an actor, and then he asked me what my name was. And I thought, well, maybe if I give him a hint. And so I said, well, my initials were RR. And with that, a face lit up, and he turned, and he ran back into the house, and he was yelling, Ma, Ma, come on out here quick. Roy Rogers is outside. But seriously, though, as I mentioned at our ceremony this morning, the people of our two countries have so much in common, not the least of which is the spirit of the frontier exemplified by the gaucho and the cowboy. More significant, however, is the bond of democracy, the love of freedom that's found in the hearts of our people. I'd like to take this opportunity to congratulate President Alfonsine, who is, on behalf of the Argentine people, accepting the International Democracy Prize from the Center for Democracy. And I can think of no finer example to others than Argentina's inspiring return to democracy. Congratulations, Mr. President. This generation of Argentinians is laying the foundation for what will be enjoyed by your fellow countrymen hundreds of years hence. And this is in keeping with the tradition of San Martin, an heroic individual, significant not only in your history, but in that of the entire hemisphere. I think it's interesting to note that once San Martin was successful in freeing half a continent, he assumed the title of protector. And that perhaps captures the essence of our responsibility. Those of us who enjoy the freedom and independence passed to us by brave and noble individuals like San Martin, Washington, and others, especially those of us in elected office, must be the protectors of liberty. This is our trust, our obligation. San Martin once said, "You will be what you must be. If not, you are nothing." President Alfonsine, you've already demonstrated to your countrymen and to all the world that you are willing to live up to the enormous trust that you hold in your hands. I look forward to working closely with you in the years ahead. I salute you. And I ask all of you to join me in a toast to President Alfonsine, Mrs. Alfonsine, and the free people of Argentina.
Señor presidente, señoras y señores, acabamos de cumplir un día de intensas, francas, cordiales y mutuamente enriquecedoras consultas. El éxito de esta jornada, marcada desde el comienzo por la excepcional hospitalidad norteamericana, mucho se debe precisamente a su calidez, señora, así como al clima a la vez informal y amistoso que supo usted, señor presidente, imprimir a nuestros encuentros. Vaya por ello el especial reconocimiento de mi esposa, de mis amigos y muy particularmente mi sincero agradecimiento a ambos.
Mr. President, Mrs. Reagan, ladies and gentlemen, we have ended a day of intense, frank, cordial, and mutually enriching consultations. The success of this day, characterized from the beginning by exceptional American hospitality, is due in great part to your warmth, Mrs. Reagan, as well as to the informal and friendly atmosphere that you, Mr. President, imparted to our meetings. My wife and my friends are sincerely grateful for this hospitality, and I sincerely thank both of you.
Al abordar diversos aspectos de la realidad internacional, hemos comprobado que existen entre nosotros amplios puntos de convergencia. Como yo la imagino, la relación entre Washington y Buenos Aires supone, lo dije al llegar y quiero reiterarlo, que asumamos la defensa de nuestros respectivos intereses nacionales desde una perspectiva de cooperación, de previsibilidad y de sinceridad mutuas.
In discussing the different aspects of international affairs, we have discovered that on many points our views converge, and as we've also discovered a few differences in our analysis, it should neither surprise us nor alarm us. As I imagine it, the relationship between Washington and Buenos Aires presupposes, and I said that when I arrived, that we assume the defense of our respective national interests from a perspective of cooperation, foresight, and mutual sincerity.
Me parece en consecuencia insoslayable, como marco general, que exploremos con cierta audacia, con imaginación y con buena voluntad, los perfiles de una relación realista y duradera entre América Latina y los Estados Unidos.
It seems to me that within this framework, we should explore with a certain amount of audacity, imagination, and goodwill, the profiles of a realistic and enduring relationship between Latin America and the United States.
Señor presidente, en su discurso inaugural, el último quiero decir, una sugestiva evocación de la revolucionaria ruptura de los Estados Unidos con el pasado me conmovió. Y cito: por primera vez en la historia el pueblo dijo, el gobierno no es nuestro amo, sino nuestro sirviente. Y el único poder del gobierno será el que nosotros, el pueblo, le permitamos tener.
Mr. President, in your inaugural address, I mean your last inaugural address, I was moved by a suggestive evocation you made of the revolutionary past of the United States, and I quote you, "For the first time in history, they said, government is not our master, but rather our servant. And the only power of government, the government will be that which we, the people, allow it to have.
¿Cómo no vincular esas palabras con uno de los fundamentos de la acción más reciente de las fuerzas democráticas en Argentina para restablecer la soberanía popular?
How can we not link these words to the basic grounds that explain what the forces of democracy have achieved in Argentina to reestablish the sovereignty of our people?
¿Cómo podrían no entenderse entonces en lo fundamental dos pueblos y dos gobiernos cuyas convicciones se nutren de tales principios?
Why should two peoples whose convictions are nourished by such principles not be able to understand one another in fundamental matters?
Sé que también compartimos una intensa preocupación por la paz en el mundo. Claro está que nuestras responsabilidades son sin duda diferentes, pero en nuestro ámbito creemos haber hecho una eficaz contribución a la distensión en el Cono Sur al resolver pacíficamente el centenario diferendo que manteníamos con Chile.
And I'm also aware of the fact that you and I share an intense concern about peace in the world. Of course, no doubt, our responsibilities are different. But in our area, we've made, I think, a great contribution to peace, because in the Southern Cone, we've settled peacefully a century-old dispute with Chile.
Señor Presidente, señora de Reagan, al levantar mi copa para brindar por vuestra aventura personal y la de todos los aquí reunidos, lo hago teniendo especialmente presente al pueblo de los Estados Unidos. A ese pueblo vaya entonces también nuestro emocionado saludo. A ese pueblo, arquitecto de una civilización donde los logros materiales han estado siempre fundados en una gran fuerza espiritual.
Mr. Salud. President, Mrs. Reagan, as I toast for your personal well-being and that of all of you here tonight, I do so having specially in mind the American people. To your people, we also offer this deeply felt tribute. They are a people who are the architects of a civilization where material achievements have always been united to a great spiritual force. Thank you very much.
Salud.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Pete Fountain. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, all you alligators. For the younger set in the crowd, that comes from a ways back. Pete Fountain and these wonderful musicians up here, he started playing when he was just a lad on Bourbon Street in New Orleans. That's their Pennsylvania Avenue. And I've got news for you. I don't know whether you're thinking about traveling or going any distance away, but I'm introducing an executive order in the morning. We're renaming Pennsylvania Avenue Bourbon Street. We can't tell you how grateful we are, and I think I speak for everyone here for what we have just heard tonight. Just magnificent. Thank you.
Thank you.